everybody, I'm Tasin here, and today I'd be making some very cheap and very good DIY speakers that you can make at home if you want to. Okay, so because I'm gonna build this at home and you can also too, and you just have to buy some very cheap parts, so I'll now show you the very cheap parts I need. Okay, so the parts we need are mainly the speakers. So these are the subwoofers that I bought from Dara's very cheaply, you can also buy. And also these, I found these like in my very old TV. Just opened the TV up and got these. Next we need the wires for the connections. And then we also need some screws. I have these all packed in. And then you need some normal tools like these. And also some crocodile clips like these you can also find cheaply. Alright, so now let's get into it and start building. Alright, so firstly we need to build the box. So for boxes I bought these. So basically these are the fruit and nuts of the dairy milk, and I'm using these boxes, but you can buy your own boxes or take them from anywhere you want. Just make it a bit hard. You can also use MDF, but it's gonna take some time, and because I want to make these very cheap, I'm gonna use these boxes, and they are 8.5 inches by 5 inches. All right so now let's get cutting into it, but before that I also want to show you the design. So the design, this is going to be the front and the subwoofer is going to be on the top, while these speakers are going to be on the like bottom of the speaker cabinet. Okay, so because these are 4x4 and these are 3.5 and 1 inch. Okay, so before we start measuring, we have to find the middle. Okay, so the middle is 2.5 because it's a 5 inch, and now we can go on to it. So make sure to be at the exact middle. Okay, so because I want to make it accurate, I'm gonna like make a hole with that pin. So now I am gonna make a circle. Well, you can make it larger, of course. So now let's get going and cut it. Alright, so it's 1/2 inch. Now we can draw this. And the next line. And now this is that speaker, alright? Okay, so you can use both the anti-cutters or scissor, whichever you want, but I'm gonna use the anti-cutter right now. So be careful with anti-cutters because they might go like this. Alright, so our first hole is okay, and now we just put it in to see if it matches. There, it fits. Nice. Oh man, nice fit. Alright, so because these are now going in their places, now we have to think about how to make these black. And for that, I'm gonna use paper and some glue to get them on. Okay. I said now we're gonna do the back panel. Okay, so for that I've also measured. Firstly, we need to find the the middle, which is here. Now I've selected at okay. Now let's see it again. It's going to look like this, okay? Right guys, now we're done. Look at that. The edges are now really looking cool. See? Pause. So I have another one now. Now all we need to do is place these in here. These very high quality cheap wires that you can use and find in your local hardware store. Anyways, I'm gonna make it a bit long so you can extend it. So the way I'm gonna use it is because these are soldered and I don't have a soldering machine, and also soldering machines cost a lot, so I'm just gonna use crocodile clips. So I have two for each, as you can see here. And the way we're gonna wire them up is like this. So these two are gonna go with this, and the main wire is gonna go from here. Alright, so now I'm just gonna take a long amount. Yeah, that's kind of long enough, I suppose. Probably it is. So you cut it a bit gently so it doesn't cut the copper off, and then you twist it so it can go easily into the terminals or crocodile clips. Make sure to do both of them, the end and also the front. Grab one box, and now first thing we're gonna do is in here and then tighten the screws. And after you've tightened all four screws, it's now fixed into place and nice. All right I fixed some tape here, and from here we are gonna put our connections. Okay, as you can see here, There are those little terminals there. Wait, 1 second, I forgot the polarity. And that's this one, the left of your side, or right of your side. Yeah, right of your side is positive and left for me. This one is positive. And make sure that it doesn't touch, okay? Or it'll short circuit. Wait. This is kind of challenging. There we go. That's how it's supposed to go in there. All right, now what we need to do is carefully put it to the subwoofer side. Now we're done with the bottom and we can finally close the box. Okay. I want to save them for later. All right, so I'll put them here. Be careful of the sharp points, of course. They look, I mean, they look really nice and they're kind of light. Not that much heavy at all. Now we're gonna do a sound test on these speakers and see how great they are. So I'm using my very mini amplifier, which has a 50 watt of two channels, ZK502MT. The voltage needed is DC 9 to 24 volts, current more than 3 amps, Bluetooth 5.0, channel 2.0, and the speaker, as you know, is 4 to 8 ohms, which is cool, and 5 to 100 watts with both of them together, okay? So now it's time to wire them up. Alright, firstly I'm doing the right channel. Make sure they're secured and you don't touch it, because at frequencies you might get shocked because they are AC voltage. I mean DC, but it's becoming AC by the frequencies. Alright, now time to power it. I'm using this adapter and 5 amps. Yes, 5 amps. Okay. Let's see if it works. Oh my god, it actually made a sound. Now I've opened my laptop. So, our first song. To the next by Marshmallow, one of my favorite songs. Oh my god, I that's the end of all the songs I'm gonna be playing. So hope you like this video, and I hope you learned something from it. And yeah, if you like the video, then make sure to like and subscribe. And I really appreciate it when you like and subscribe, and hope you have some fun with these, and have a great day.